What's up everyone, this is Kurt and I'm super excited to bring you another awesome tutorial. This time we are going to delve into the world of metal shaders and see how we can create a truly thrilling and detailed metal material. Whether you are a beginner or an advanced artist, you are going to love what I have in store for you today. Now, I know that metal shaders can seem intimidating at first, but with the help of Maya and Arnold, we are going to make it easy and accessible for everyone. We will cover all the essential steps, from the initial setup to the final render. And by the end of this video, you will have a solid understanding of how to make amazing metal shaders of your own. So get relaxed, grab a coffee or cup of tea, and let's roll the intro!
So guys, the first thing we need to make this realistic metal shader is an interesting model. So if you are looking for some awesome scan 3D models, myminifactory.com is the website you have to know. If we look a moment to the setup of the scene, it's pretty basic. We've got a studio backdrop, an HDRI, a rim light and a key light on the right to accentuate the direction of the global composition, and a small light on the left to fill a bit the head area. The outliner hierarchy is pretty clean as I like it. Okay, so let's begin by creating an AE standard surface. Now we can assign it to the model. Also, let's launch the IPR. Okay, we can change the color of the base to something greenish. Let's darken it. Change the roughness to 0.55 as it will be an old metal. And switch the metalness to 1. We can rename the shader properly and the shader engine too. Okay, let's focus first on the base color. Create an AE noise and plug it to the base color. Isolate the noise to see what we are doing. Let's take the values to have something interesting. Then we can input two colors, a dark green and a dark gray. Now we can create a second AE noise to create even more variations. Let's tweak the values to have something interesting and a bit different. Now we can create an AE layer RGBA to mix the two noise together. Let's plug them into input 1 and input 2. We can change the balance of the mix by changing the mix values. Okay, so create a file node. And let's select this interesting texture. Because it's a scalar map, switch the color space to row. Now we can create a quick triplanar node to avoid creating UVs on the model. Let's change the scale to something bigger. So to do so, lower the value in the scale inputs. Lower the value again. Sweet. And now we can plug the map in the AE layer RGBA mix. And its out color to the base color. Nice. Let's use an AE range to remap the mix texture. Let's lower the output max value and add contrast. Yeah, much better. We've got a nice base color for our metal. Now we can focus on our roughness. Let's plug our AE range to the specular roughness. It's way too glossy. Let's create another AE range to remap the value and plug it like this. Let's multiply the output max by 4. Better. And lower the output min to 0.2. I'm checking the pixel information to understand the range value of the roughness map. Let's lower also the contrast to have more subtle variations. Nice. Now let's create some bumpiness on the surface with the map. So we can create a file node, an AE triplanar, and connect it to the bump mapping slot in the shader. Okay, now let's pick our texture. This one is pretty interesting. Because it's a scalar map, switch the color space to row. Obviously, it's way too much strong. Let's change a bit the value of the map and lower the bump value. Better, but let's lower again the bump value. Really nice.
Hey you, I know you're watching my video and I know you're not subscribed yet. It's literally so easy, just go down there and boom, press subscribe. So like this video, comment and hit the subscribe button. Now back to this sweet shader.
Okay, so this was the first step. Now let's create a rust material. Create a new AE standard surface. Let's rename the shader properly. I will use a Megascan material for this one. So let's create three files node. one for the color, one for the roughness, and one for the normal. Let's plug the textures. Switch to RAW for the roughness and the normal map. Let's plug them accordingly. Whoops, I forgot to create an eye triplanar node. So let's create them and change the scale of them. The scale is a bit too small. Let's tweak the value. Sweet. Let's lower the specular value to 0.2 and change the specular color to a pale pink. Also, we can reduce the IR value. Now we can adjust a bit the base color. We can create an eye color correct node. Let's tweak the value. Nice. Adjusting the scale value again. Then, the third step is to merge the metal and the rest together. To do so, create an eye mix shader. Plug the metal in shader 1 and the rest in shader 2. As you can see, if we change the mix weight value, it switches from metal to rust. Now let's create something interesting to drive the mix. First, let's create a file node and pick this map. Change the color space to RAW. Create an eye triplanar and eye range node. You know the drill now. Let's change the scale of the map in the eye triplanar node. Sweet. In the eye range node, we can tweak the values. Nice. Okay, then let's create an eye curvature node and an eye range. And finally, an eye layer RGBA to merge the two things together. Plug the different nodes like this. And now let's tweak our curvature node. Okay, sweet. Now in the eye layer RGBA, we can activate layer 2. Lower the mix value and in the layer 1, input a mix value of 0.5. With this method, you can balance the presence of the rusts on the curvature and the overall surface. Pretty nice. To have an even more interesting effect, we can input the map of the spread or the curvature. Really nice. Okay, now the last step, let's add some dirt. Let's create an eye standard surface once more. Change the base color to a dark gray. The diffuse roughness to 0.5. The roughness to 0.65. And the IR to 1.2. Then we can create the mix shader and plug the nodes like this. Now to drive the mix, let's create an eye ambient occlusion node, as the dirt is present in the occluded areas. Let's create also an eye range to remap the values and plug the nodes together as it follows. Now in the eye ambient occlusion node, let's invert the black and white colors. Reduce the spread to 0.3. Let's change the color of the dirt temporarily, just to see it better. Nice. Let's decrease the spread value and increase the samples. To have an even more interesting effect, we can input this map in the spread of the ambient occlusion. Let's change back the color of the dirt to a dark color. If we compare the render before and after adding the dirt, as you can see, it really sells the effect. And boom, the final result. Really, really nice. What do you think, guys? This is a really cool way of doing some realistic old metal shaders.
Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the content, you know what to do. Subscribe to my channel for more awesomeness. And I see you guys in the next video.